and I'm one of those rebels.
And I am too. So this is our first time going to Disneyland. Well, it's my first time going to Disneyland. It's your second time going to Disneyland?
Yeah, second time. I went when I was 14.
And I've never gone before, although I've gone to Disney World many, 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 many times. But this is my first time going to Disneyland, and we're going to go during the 3 preview weeks of Star Wars Galaxy's Edge. We got a stay at Paradise Pier Hotel for one night only, but you only get one reservation for your entire stay, so it doesn't matter if you booked 7 nights or if you booked 1 night, you still get one 4-hour reservation slot. So we actually got our email 2 days ago now with our confirmation time. So we'll be going bright and early at 8 a.m. to 12 p.m. We got a nice early slot, which we're very excited for. What is the first thing you want to do when you go?
All right, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to hit up the Cantina bar.
At 8 a.m.?
Yeah, I'm going to start the day early, and I'm going to get some blue milk, like how Luke Skywalker got blue milk from the, I forgot what that monster thing was called.
Bantha titties?
Yeah, Bantha titties. I'm going to go on a ride, but there's only two rides.
So there's only two rides. No, there's only one ride right now. So Star Wars Rise of the Resistance will be opening later, and that one's going to be epic, and I'll probably go to that in like 2 years in Hollywood Studios, or next year when it's open. But it's like, seriously, it's going to be a marvel of a ride. It's going to be like a 55-person trackless vehicle going through like 3 different scenes. You're going to pass by 2 full-size AT-ATs. It's going to be amazing. And you're going to see Kylo Ren, and you're going to see Rey and Poe and Finn. So it's going to be pretty amazing.
All right. Can you describe to the viewers the Millennium Falcon
Smuggler's
Run ride?
Colton,
because
Smoke. Yes.
Because I have no idea what to expect for that ride.
So, and this is all just things I've heard from other podcasts or read obsessively about. But, so the queue line will be going around the Millennium Falcon, so you'll be able to see it, you know, from the side and from the top, so you'll get pretty cool views of it. And then the queue will also lead you into the Millennium Falcon, so we'll have some time to play, like, holo chess, even though I don't know how to play real chess.
Holo chess?
Mm-hmm. And you'll get some cool photo ops inside the Millennium Falcon, so that'll be cool. And then you actually become a pilot or an engineer or one other type of, like a navigator or something.
Wait, you get like assigned a role?
Mm-hmm. There are 6 people per little pod, so I'm not sure how good the ride capacity will be, but hopefully, you know, with that reservation system, we won't have to wait too long. We have a 4-hour period in there, and I'd really like to get everything crossed off our list. So, you know, the blue milk, the ride, checking out the merchandise, eating some food, and getting a pork puppet.
Pork puppet? Wait, so we have 4 hours in there, but there's only one ride, so
One ride, but depending on how many people they're letting in, we could wait 4 hours.
Oh, yeah. But I'm wondering how many people they're going to let in total, like... Because we have
big speculation.
Because we have the 4-hour time slot. So, like, I feel like it'll only be, like, maybe 300 people at once. Or do you think it'll be more?
Well, okay. This is the thing. This is why I wanted to go to Disneyland for the opening. Because Disney World is not going to have a reservation system. So that's going to be madness. Like, pure utter chaos. And Hollywood Studios cannot handle that kind of
Oh,
crowd
so
right
only
now.
Disneyland's going to have the reservation?
Yeah, only Disneyland has that 3-week period where you have to have a reservation. And so right now it's only hotel guests, and there are only 3 hotels at Disneyland as opposed to like the 1 billion hotels at Disney World. So I'm thinking the chances of crowds that are low are pretty good, but they're opening up reservations May 2nd. So go make a Disneyland account right now if you haven't gotten one already, so you can get a reservation May 2nd, even though they don't.
All right, so we got blue milk bantha titties, pork puppets, pork puppets, and the Millennium Falcon Smuggler's Run ride. What other things can we expect from the Star Wars Galaxy's Edge?
Cool merch, bruh.
What type of merch?
So you'll be able to build your own lightsaber, and they'll have kyber crystals, and it'll be a very intimate experience. So I think they're gonna let only like 16 people in at a time, so that's another thing that I kind of want to get in on. But the lightsabers themselves are gonna cost like $160, so I'm like,
you know, we're getting one of those lightsabers though. We can split one together and have it be like a decoration in our room.
I kind of like want like a purple Mace Windu lightsaber, you know?
Yeah, I do.
That'd be pretty cool.
I do want a purple Mace Windu lightsaber.
Okay, then we can just get one and share.
And what about the, supposedly there's a droid that follows you, like...
Oh yeah, okay, so in all the original concept art, and that has changed over the years, you know, there were supposed to be droids that like interact with you as you walk through the land. I'm not sure if that's gonna happen when we're there.
No.
Because the lands are opening in phases. But you can purchase a droid, you can purchase a C-3PO, and you can like take his head off, and when you put it back on, he'll like, be like, hey.
But you can't like customize your own droid?
I think you can, yeah. You can build your own droid, but so far what they released is that you can get a C-3PO, or you can get a Rex, which is from the original Star Tours ride.
Wait, what's the Rex?
He's just the droid that guides you on your journey when you're on the original Star Tours.
Oh, okay. Okay, and then also, what type of food can we expect at Star Wars Galaxy's Edge?
Okay, so they haven't been super forthcoming with the food options, and I don't know if I'll be able to eat anything there because I'm allergic to everything, but they're gonna have like some sort of spitfire meat option and a vegetarian option that's tofu, but they call it like chicken, and it's like in squares.
Do you think they'll have fried porgs there for consumption? Okay, on a scale of zero to lit, how awesome do you think that Star Wars Galaxy's Edge is going to be?
Well, I'm a very, very big fan of the Wizarding World of Harry Potter over at Disney's rival Universal Studios. I've only been to the one in Florida because it's better. You have Diagon Alley and you've got Hogsmeade, but that's for another video, I guess. So I'm expecting something on that level of theming. And if we can get to the point where like you have me in tears while I'm walking through your theme park, then I guess we'll have to wait and see.
All right, so stay tuned and see if Christina is going to be in tears at Star Wars Galaxy's Edge.
I'll probably be in tears just going to Disneyland and going to Toontown.
There will be tears either way, but we'll see how she feels at Star Wars Galaxy's Edge.
And I mean, like, okay, I've never even been to Cars Land, so that will be... that will be big for me.
Okay, expect a full Disneyland cinematic video highlighting Star Wars Galaxy's Edge on June 11th.
We're gonna go June 11th.
Yeah, we're gonna
go. We don't know when the video is coming.
Yeah, the video will come out afterwards, but June 11th from 8 a.m. to 12 p.m. is our Star Wars Galaxy's Edge reservation.
Don't tell everybody.
Well, in case...
They try and steal our identity.
In case one of my 26 subscribers is there, too. They can say hi to me.
Hi, Isabel. And as always, Dattebayo.